But tonight we're really excited. We have Craig Wetzel with us, and I can see by the size of the crowd that you're really excited to see him too. He just finished the mural on the side of the building downtown. He painted one of my ex-girlfriends on the side of that building. But she had both eyes when we dated in high school. So, well, without further ado, I'm going to turn the program over to Craig. And as I said, we're happy to have him here tonight. And let's welcome Craig.
Suggested that I picture everybody in their underwear. I'm really glad I don't have stage fright, because looking at the group out here, that's a blast thing. What I'm going to do, you know what, I forgot one important thing in the car. Where's Nathaniel? And when I'm done, I do have one box of the books that I'm going to sell. So if anybody wants one tonight. And until the real thing gets here, there's an illustration I did of Pete. Please, if you have any questions at any time, interrupt me, because I find questions a lot more fun than just standing up here talking. I did this one first because this is the one I used on the cover of the book. Has anybody been to this place in Negley? If you have, it's no exaggeration whatsoever what it looks like. If anything, it's a bit restrained. No idea whose house this is or where it's at. I think it was on 5th Street? 4th Street? Probably somebody who's here, it's their house. Here he comes.
Just little.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the reason you're here. Clapping for a pine cone. Any questions? Yes.
So when you paint, you know, when you do this, do you go out, do you just go to remember it? Do you take a picture of it? Are you there on the side, sketching away?
I generally just go snap a picture with my phone and do it. I suppose that was Danny. Yeah, I generally just take a photo with my phone and then sketch them either at home or at the office.
Is that in watercolor? Is it always watercolor?
I sketch them in ink and then just squish watercolor. By the time I get the ink done, the watercolor is basically like coloring. Well, yeah. The pine cone is generally in about every vein. I know this is on 4th 4th Street, I remember doing this one.
Do you stick with the colors, or do you change them?
Pardon?
Do you stick with the colors of the buildings, or do you change?
No, I stick with the colors mostly. Yeah, I mean, I don't get too particular about it. With this one, I painted, or I drew the top of it that's no longer there, and so I didn't paint that. That is, I don't know, is that where Newcastle School of Trades is there?
It's the left one, yeah, the old 5 and 10.
Yeah. McCrory's, right?
McCrory's.
This one, I'm pretty sure, is on 5th Street. You're going to argue with me, aren't you?
That one that was at Patrice Brown's, right from the corner of Dr. Orley's office?
Yeah, that's what I thought it was.
Yeah.
I know where this one is. This is right next to the Sturgis house.
Yeah.
Across the alley. Who?
Dr. Marshall's house.
Dr. Marshall? And if anybody's interested in prints of any of these, I can do prints real easy because I have images of about all of these.
If you look close, you can see her looking out the window.
I wish they were all horizontal because they show up so much better. This one isn't in the book. This was my Uncle Denver's house and his one of his Dalmatians, hopefully one of the nice ones.
All of them except Tuffy. Craig, your signature, is it Sir Craig?
Yeah. Just about. Unless I forget it once in a while. I've actually had people send them back and say, you forgot the pine cone.
I see it right there. Here's
Pete's not usually drawn to scale. He'd be about 3 foot high if he was that size. And going with the Uncle Denver theme, this was the old dry cleaners, which is the coffee shop now.
Steely.
I never
looked
like the fingers on it.
Was the
Oddfellows.
I guess
is that what it was? The Oddfellows?
Way back
in the years. Well, it was still Oddfellows when Uncle Denver was there.
Teddy bears on the balcony now.
Oh, they do?
Yeah.
As a general rule, I don't paint teddy bears. Scott Shepherd suggested one day something about wouldn't it make a nice center for the arts. And so I stuck a paintbrush on the side of it. I don't know where you'd actually get a giant paintbrush like that. It would be nice if something could be done with the building.
Yes, it would.
Because it's a cool building. Does everybody remember this place?
Yes.
I think this is on what, Jackson Street? Jefferson Street?
They look so much better than what they are now.
Yeah, well, they tend to, yes.
They're so much brighter.
And the Sturgis House. A lot of these I changed somewhat in the book, not this one, but some of them I added signs and stuff.
How about Silver's, the old fire station?
That's really exactly where it is.
Yeah, the old fire station.
That's on Saint, is that on?
This is one that everybody likes.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, it looks so much more beautiful.
Yeah, I did this last year for somebody for Christmas, and I don't even remember who I did it for, but then I sold a lot of prints of it.
That's beautiful. The top looks so much more.
It's going to look that way again when I
hear
that.
Hopefully.
Even better. This is one of my favorites. I don't remember the name of the people that were in that mausoleum. There's a couple skeletons. I think they're trying to get out.
It'd be so great to be that talented. Oh.
Well, they're just looking out the window. I don't think it takes any talent.
I think that's pretty cool.
I mean, being dead might not be that fun. There's the synagogue. I don't think it's empty now, right?
Another good solid building or something.
Yeah, I don't think there's any Jewish people left in town. Looks familiar, right? Yeah, that's where the appliance store. I always remember it as Superior Paint because I worked there.
The liquor store.
And my father-in-law owned it, so a liquor store.
Yeah.
That I saw, they were all had Smith and Phillips signs on them, and they all were different, had different signs.
Wow.
Yeah.
That goes back a lot of years.
I remember I used to go to the barber shop in that wee little one.
Oh, it was sandwiched in,
huh? Yeah.
Huh.
That's
what? Episcopal Church?
Yeah, across the street from our food bank.
Some of these you'll notice are quite different in the book. I think his house was out on St. Clair.
It's pretty close to the fire station. Yes? Is it the one right up above the fire station?
No.
No? Oh, okay. Okay, gotcha. Your cable. Yeah, it was Smith's.
I don't know what used to be. It used to be in this building way back.
On the corner.
Bernie's Pharmacy.
Pharmacy?
Wow. There must have been apartments or something up in there when they were.
Yes? That's all related to coffee consumption. This is like four cups. Likes this place. I hear all the murmuring.
You need to pass out Kleenex for that.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's how it was. That's how it was.
And this, I think, is the dumbest looking building in East Liberty.
That poor thing.
It looks like a kitchen appliance.
I don't think it was our first drive to the drive through bank.
Oh, that, yeah, it was nice. It was quite unique. It looks like an appliance.
It's just soldiers.
Oh, I know where that is. Our guys split oils.
Yeah. Yeah, I think everybody recognizes this house, probably. It's hard to miss, especially Phil, right? This one's kind of more realistic than most. This is snow coffee. Find your water. City Hall, north of City Hall on 6th Street, same size. There's two buildings together there,
yep.
Nice
yes,
little buildings.
Yes, yes, and it used to be the Elite Diner was on the other side.
Yes, yeah, exactly. Yeah, I have a photo in here somewhere of the other.
Oh my!
It's got Jamila Sprucedale.
Yeah, Hamilton's
Oh.
that's the other one that's there.
That was a grand building at one point.
I bet you. Yeah, that had to be.
And then this is like one of the favorites I've done. Everybody loves this place. I've sold so many prints of this one.
Not bad.
About how much does it print cost?
$20.
I did have a showing with Tazio Gilbert. Have you seen her painting of Orlando's?
Yeah. Tazio and Lisa Zimmerman. And she always wanted the pottery, so I gave her that one there. Most of these, I put names and stuff on them later in the computer, but some of these I went ahead and did it before. And this is my parents' house where I grew up. Well, where I started the process, anyway. I don't even know what the street's called now. Where are they? Fisher.
Some people wouldn't even know where an antenna is.
This is the one they tore down.
Smith Building. Cover the Smith Building.
Next year's book is going to be exclusively buildings that are gone. But there are a few in this book. Most of them are buildings that are still standing, but there are a few in this book that were torn down. And this one was a shame, I think.
Yeah, it should never have gone.
I was on his mortgage. That's a blast from the past.
This is the one where I did the mural.
The quality stamps.
Right.
It looks
worse on the left side.
The bridge.
The bridge?
That would be cool. I look at those steps going up so I can. Is there a house there? Is there a house down there?
On Sinclair.
That's haunted.
It's haunted, yeah. This is the I don't think he's here. I don't remember the name of it. It was in California Hollow.
McDevitt Moore.
So I did this for Tim Brooks, but then I never remember the name of it. And this is another one of my favorites out of all of them, one I did at the museum.
That's cool.
You're in a lot of chatter out there, let's pay attention. This actually wasn't supposed to be funny. I should have known someone would ask.
Also, the church, the Calvary Church.
Yeah, this is Long's Run Church. Anybody recognize this house?
It's up by the high school.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, on Main Boulevard.
Yeah. I wonder who he lives in.
No, he doesn't. Yeah, they can't.
Oh, kidding. That's old.
I always remember how kidding used to smell when you went in there. It had the best smell. And this is just a barn. I'm not allowed to say where. I mean, it's not an Apple store.
No. Oh, is that where the children's shop used to be?
No.
Is it going toward the hospital from the pizza shop on the corner?
No. No, it's right on the main part between.
Montgomery Ward.
Yeah, that's what we say, yeah. Montgomery Ward.
Oh.
Now it's the Apple store. Is down somewhere on, I think, Jefferson Street, maybe, or even further down. It's just a nondescript old garage. I made it into an antique barn. Gaston's Mill.
Yeah, Gaston's Mill.
And the G.A.R. Chapel. I think this one's on Fifth Street too.
I think that's Patrice's house where she lives.
Oh wow.
That's
the same house.
No, it's next to same house. Next to the rectory.
Oh, okay. But
yeah.
I thought I recognized it.
That's where Lisa's the pastor.
Hmm.
Dawson.
That's real familiar.
Well, if it doesn't look familiar yet, it will.
Unfortunately, we get to walk out of it every day.
Eventually.
This is a little church in Fredericktown.
And next to Isley's?
You need to enlarge that so the people in the back can read that.
Oh, they'll read it in the book.
Most guys. That's weird.
That's Jefferson Street.
Yeah, this is on Jefferson Street. This is a cool old house.
1860s.
Is that how old it is?
And the house beside it looked a whole lot like it. And then they took it down and put the education wing on the Presbyterian church.
I don't know where this one was. I don't remember. Fifth Street. Seriously, at 7:30? just laziness. Yeah, I put one time somebody. I do a lot of these houses and stuff for realtors, different places in the country. And one time I tried polka dots and I had to redo it. So I just leave them white now. This is an adventure. I act like this is the real Pete. I just grabbed one of 100 pine cones, and when he gets broken up, I'll toss it in the trash and get another one, and nobody knows the difference. I think this is on the diamond, right? This is kind of hard to do because there's nothing really. I changed something in the book, but really, just on the rock, there's nothing to relate to, so you see the size. This one is on Dresden.
Oh, it is, yes.
Yeah, kind of.
By the red light.
I think it looks a little better than what it on
much
here
better.
Than what it does in
yeah,
the
much, much better. Oh.
That's on 4th Street.
Yeah, that's on 4th
Street. I remember that one. Bob, you paying attention?
Yes, sir. Scary Mark.
That's Tim's law office. At least it was till he retired.
Tim Brooks's, yeah.
And the carriage house. This is down East End. I think it's part of the street.
It's right on the main street. Yeah, right on the main drive.
Oh,
there's
the Chester Bridge.
Yeah, it's your bridge. No, no more.
I don't even know. What is this? First Christian Church? Something like that?
First Church of Christ.
That's
what I'm college? I'm college student?
Yeah.
I thought that was a synagogue. Is that a big house? Oh, my. That's a big house.
Yeah, I did. This, I think, is my favorite one that I did, the one at the Thompson House.
Oh, that's beautiful. Yeah. Wow.
That's really
strange. That's all I put on here. I didn't want to do too many, and I can tell I'm hearing more and more chatter as I do. I wanted to mention the art show we're having. Tazio Hilbert and Lisa Zimmerman with their pottery. And then me down at the Venture Gallery, the second and third of December. You probably are sick enough of me not to stop, but I would recommend stopping for the other two because they both do good work.
Yeah.
bunch of local paintings for this show.
Yeah, that's a different thing.
And I put this here because I always forget.
Thank you.
I do have, you got a question?
Yes. I came because I want to know about people. I'm a late comer.
Yeah.
I can get on the bandwagon until a little bit later. They probably know I'm a
okay,
lot.
Well, ask your question.
I want to know how he came about. How did
he well, if you really want to know.
Yes, I do.
Because this goes way back. Okay, well, it was the year I graduated.
What year was that?
That was 1982. Maybe it was the year after I graduated, but I had just finished up my college career, which coincidentally was about 6 months after I finished my high school career. And I had a girlfriend, and we went, are you paying attention? And we went to the park, and she gave me a pine cone, and then she dumped me. But I kept a pine cone for some reason, I don't know why, and yeah, this is really true, yeah. Yeah. So far. No, this is the truth. So I had this, it was a hemlock pine cone, just a wee little one, and I kept it in my truck, and then when I got a new car, I put it in my car, and I had it up, even when I got married, I had it, and one day, we hadn't been married long, and my wife was helping me clean out my car. With the fact that she's helping me clean out my car is an indication that we hadn't been married long. She said, you want me to clean the windows or vacuum? And I said, I'll clean the windows, you vacuum. And she said, what's this pine cone? And I said, don't mess with it. It belonged to my girlfriend. I heard. So, I mean, this is a reminder. Let your wife do the windows. But I've been getting her back for many years now. And as far as a girlfriend, I got the last laugh with her, too, because she married a preacher. So that's basically.
Then how did Pete end up in your paintings?
Well, I just started. I just, you know.
You just did it one day, and then
sometimes just something pops into your head, and I just put it in my signature, and the next thing I put it in one of the paintings, and then. And it was probably you. Somebody started asking about it. And the next thing I know, believe it or not, I've actually sent pictures of Pete to people. They've bought just portraits of Pete. I mean, we're talking about a pine cone. But anyway, that was how it started.
Since all pine cones are female, how do you account for Pete's?
Somebody's checking up on you. mostly that I like the building more. Just for some reason, doing two-story buildings are always more fun and turn out better than one-story buildings. I don't know why that is. And a lot of the late 19th century architecture in East Liverpool is just, especially when you start looking at it like you have to do when you're drawing it, it's just really good. It's really interesting. You notice all kinds of details and embellishments that you don't really see driving around town.
Did you ever think to do the Caywood House?
No.
No?
No. Well, I can't say I didn't think of doing the Caywood House, but
it's a grand
old. I haven't done it. No.
It's a grand old.
Yeah. Yeah, I may do it one of these days.
Before it falls in. It's
yeah, sad. Before it falls. Well, that's the same with a lot of the ones I've done.
Craig, is the Thompson building going to be on the poster? Is it on the poster?
I think so.
Craig, you said you brought books for
yes.
tonight, and if someone, I know last year you did house paintings leading up to Christmas, that's still...
Yes, if anybody's interested in a painting of their house or outhouse or dog house or garden shed,
how much does that go?
$75.
It's where you are.
So if anybody, I brought a box of books. They are $25 if anybody wants one.
And he's committed to stick around until the...
Yeah, I'll stick around until you quit handing me money.
And if you want a painting of your house, just put your information down and I'm sure he'll get back to you. But let's show you how much we appreciate it.